Hey guys, today I'm going to be doing a read in pink on the Hunger Games. I haven't done a read in pink in such a long time. I know, but I've been reading books after Harry Potter, obviously, but I just didn't feel the need to do read in pinks on them until Hunger Games. And my thought about Hunger Games is that I love it so, so much. I love every book I read so much, and I appreciate every book I read also. It's kind of... I know I talk about Harry Potter and every single reading pink, but it's kind of hard getting off of Harry Potter after reading it so long, but I'm definitely getting away from that, and it's getting a lot easier now. I will be rereading Harry Potter eventually, but not for now. But Hunger Games, I would never compare to Harry Potter because they're totally different genres and the age they're trying to shoot for. Just they're very different. So I would never... compare them. Although Harry Potter will always be my favorite, I do love Hunger Games, and this is a really good book. So I'm actually been reading it on my Nook. This is my Nook tablet. Love it so much, and this is a really, really awesome thing. I don't know, I just love it. But yesterday I was in class, and we do sometimes, well, most of the days, for like 30 minutes, we just sit and we just read silently, and we're allowed to pull out our Nooks or Kindles or whatever you have, or just a normal book, of course. And yeah, so I have Hunger Games right here. I'll be purchasing the second and third book soon so that I can just have a row of the three books. And I'm going to read, I need to start reading the second book. I haven't started yet. So yeah, but it's just right here. And it'll open up and that's the end. And you probably shouldn't read if you haven't read the book yet. But yeah, so I just finished it. And the way they ended it was, I was like, how can you end it in such a cliffhanger? I was like, oh my gosh, you're such a good writer. I was like, oh my gosh. But I don't know, this book is really, really good. I feel like I'm just supposed to hold it up. This is a book, but it's not really a book, it's a Nook. But, you know. So this book is basically about the Hunger Games. Someone asked me what it was about. I said, the Hunger Games. And they're like, well, what's it about? I'm like, the Hunger Games. And they're like, I know, but that's like the book name. Like, oh my gosh. So, basically, the Hunger Games is, the book is based in District 12 and then into the place that the Hunger Games is in. So, the main characters are Katniss, Primrose, and their mom, Gale. There's Peeta, who is very important. And every year, the capital, who kind of has rule over all these districts, and where they live, it's District 1 through 12, and then there's also 13, but it's kind of burned down to flames and not used anymore. No one really cares for it, so it's just District 12, and Katniss lives in the last district, District 12, along with Peeta and Gale and Primrose, her younger sister, and everybody else who lives there. And they're kind of, where they live is very poor. Katniss hunts for her family. Her dad has passed away. Her mom is sick and can't really fend for her kids, so Katniss hunts illegally with Gale, and brings home food for Primrose and her mom. Prim has a goat that she loves, and you know, it's a very interesting thing to read, the way that their life works. I was baffled, and the thing about this is more realistic than than Harry Potter and other books, you know, and it's kind of interesting because this could happen. It probably won't, but it could. So it's a really interesting thing to read and kind of learn about. And so they're living in a very kind of like tiptoe around kind of area where anything could happen and you don't really know. Kind of scary, and it's, you know, it's hard to get food and you're hungry, and lots of selling goes on. And there's the capital, and the capital is like the main, like the capital is rule over everything. So it's kind of crazy to read about the Capitol, I gotta say. And they host a thing called the Hunger Games every year. And two tributes from each district are chosen, and they pull out your name from the little thing. So there's a certain amount of times you need to or can choose to put your name in. I'm not going to go into that because it's not too important, but you know, the names. And every year, you just do not want to be called. It's, and in some districts, in out of the 12, they get an honor to get called for that. Some, like District 12, do not like the idea whatsoever and do not want to be called, nothing like that. But when the Hunger Games for this year call the ticket thing, the name comes out for the girl. It's Primrose Everdeen, and Katniss. What you were reading and hearing her feelings, and I mean reading her feelings, it was written very well. And she volunteered to be a tribute instead of her sister, which is a very, very nice thing to do. Most people don't do that. So and that's allowed. And I don't know, I just thought it was such a sweet thing. And I knew, I thought that Katniss was going to be, I was reading, I was like, okay, Katniss is so going to be called. I'm so scared. I was just so scared. And I was like, well, obviously she is. Then what would the point of the books be, you know? And I was like, oh my gosh. And then Primrose called, I was even more devastated. I was like, no. And so when Katniss volunteered, Effie Trinket, who was kind of the, like, deals with, like, not deals with all this, but it's like, pulls the names and all that. She's decked out in makeup, craziness. And she's, like, all excited. And then she calls the boy, and it's Peeta Mellark. And I'm sure I said Mellark, right? I don't know, but it's Peeta Mellark. And none of his siblings would volunteer for him. But he is around Katniss's age, so it's kind of a team. But they have a certain, they have a weird kind of background, so it's kind of hard for them. I mean, they explain the background later, but I'm not going to go into that. But they're together, and they really, Katniss obviously probably wanted Gale, who is her hunting partner, things like that. So they go to the games, and there's a whole week of training, and just, you're kind of really pampered, but you still have to realize that in a few days you're going to be in this place you don't even know where it is. The games are always in something somewhere you just don't know. You could be in something super cold, something super hot. You could be in a desert. You could be, I don't know, in the ocean. Well, probably not the ocean, but like you could be in the forest, anywhere. And when it's time, the games are, I was thinking, I was like, I don't want to get the games. All the stylist stuff is so fun to read and all the girly things. And then I was like, and then when I started reading the games, I was like, oh my gosh, this is where I wanted to read. The games are amazing. So I'm not going to give you guys any more information because I told you guys what happened. I would be spoiling everything for the games. But yeah, so go ahead. I really recommend reading this book. The ending is amazing. And the way you are kind of, you don't really know what to think. You're like, so is this going to happen? Is that going to happen? Or is, why is he doing this? Why is she doing this? Why are they doing this? And all this is just complicated. And the end makes you really sad. And it also makes you really, really want to read the second book. So, I don't know. I definitely recommend this. My next reading pink will most likely be the second Hunger Games book. So this is the first one. Oh, the one that's over here, you shouldn't read it because it has the end right there. But it kind of says end of book one right there. I think that's kind of cool. But yeah, so that's just the Hunger Games, my review of the Hunger Games, the first book. So that's my reading pink, and I hope you guys enjoyed. And go ahead and go pick up that book on your Nook, your Kindle. Go to the bookstore and get it. Go to your, maybe your school library might not have it. I don't really know. Mine doesn't, just because we have a lot of younger kids and it's kind of a gory book, but you know, so go ahead and check this book out. Thank you for watching. Bye.